is to, you know, get them to Austin, or to get them to Nashville, or to get them even to Washington, D.C.
You also have the benefit, though, unlike a lot of other schools or institutions, mm-hmm. that you have professional actors volunteering time through After SAG.
Yeah.
You have top-level professionals coming in to speak to your different classes and groups of people who study there, which maybe gives that extra edge, too.
It helps. Well, we have a film school, graduate-level film school, which is extraordinary. And we do work, have a great partnership with the Screen Actors Guild, which it has great synergy. The young filmmakers at the school who are making movies as part of the curriculum are very talented and working with masters, learning from the masters. So for them, it gives them the gift of experienced actors, because it can be a great tell in your student film if your star is your roommate's cousin, as opposed to an actor with training who's really trying to make a career. So that is a great help for them. And for the actors, it gives them the benefit of working with really professional, skilled filmmakers, and they get a reel. You know, and relationships with people who are going to be working in the industry.
Well, you've had so many people who have gone on to win awards with the films that they've done, so maybe some of those people who helped them along the way have the benefit of getting to work with them in their professional careers also, I would guess.
Absolutely, absolutely.
So what are some of the big highlights you have this year that people will be surprised or be able to see?
At AFI Fest?
Absolutely.
Oh, there are so many. Each evening there is a great gala screening, and
yes.
Even this afternoon, Bernardo Bertolucci came to show a remastered version of The Last Emperor. And then in the sort of new auteur section, a great young filmmaking team with 7 AFI alum on it was screening a film that premiered in Toronto called We Gotta Get Out of This Place.
Oh, the one that's actually